answer. The questions are yours. I go to the Bible to find answers, and thank you for these good questions we're using again today. Question number one, is it a sin to refuse to kneel to pray? Well, the Bible tells us to pray without ceasing, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 17. Whether we're walking or eating or studying or working, whatever we're to do, one preacher has said that the rarest thing that you can ever find is a praying heart, a heart that prays all the time. Kneeling, of course, speaks of humility and surrender. I suggest that you kneel to pray whenever it's possible to do so. But the Bible tells us of people who prayed while walking and while serving and while in chains, even while in prison. If it is pride that is keeping you from kneeling to pray, then read what God says in 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 23, that pride is as the sin of witchcraft. And so if you're too proud to bend your knee to pray, remember that it's a sin to rebel against God. It's your heart attitude that really matters. And now let's get to question number two. If Job was a perfect man, why did God allow Satan to attack him? Well, Job chapter 1 tells us that Satan said that nobody serves God for nothing. In other words, God has to bribe people in order to get them to serve him. Now, God said something very different. He said that my saints love me for my own sake and not for the loaves and fishes. And so God, in the book of Job, is demonstrating to everybody that true believers love him and serve him, not for the rewards that he gives to them, but simply because they love the Lord. And so God demonstrated all of that by allowing Satan to strip Job of everything that he had. And Job came through the test, of course, saying this, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. Chapter 13, verse 15. And he said, I know that my Redeemer liveth, and the last day he shall stand upon the earth, and I shall see him for myself and not another. The Bible is filled with stories of people like Moses and Abraham and St. Paul who loved and served God even though it cost them a great deal. They loved God for his own sake. And that's what the book of Job is demonstrating. And now question number three, what is sin? Is smoking a sin? Well, by the way, I doubt if you can imagine Jesus with a cigarette in his mouth. Enough said. But now, what is sin? There are three Bible verses that I want to leave with you today which answer that question. James chapter 4, verse 17, if any man knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is sin. Romans 14, verse 23, that which is not of faith is sin. And 1 John chapter 3, verse 4, sin is the transgression of the law. If you really want to know what sin is, face those three scriptures, and I'm sure you will find the answer. Thank you for these good questions. I trust the answers have been a blessing. If you have a question you'd like me to use on the Bible as the answer, please write it out, send it to me. I'll be delighted to hear from you, and I'll get to your question on the air just as quickly as I can. When you write, all the address you need is simply Faith to Live By, Box 426, Winnipeg, Manitoba. And the code is R3C2H6. Let's listen now to Heidi and Rick. The beautiful number, I know that my Redeemer liveth.